Gabrielle is with us in Sacramento, California. Hi, Gabrielle. How are you?
Hi, I'm doing wonderful. Thank you so much for talking to me. I'm really excited.
My pleasure. How can I help?
Yes, so I just had a question about making a budget on kind of a fluid income. So my husband works for a church. We also own two small businesses, and I am a server as well. Mm-hmm. But we get paid kind of as we go.
Sure.
So as we do a job or as I serve, that's how we make our income. Mm-hmm. And so I was just wondering, what is your advice for that kind of a lifestyle, you know, for that kind of an income? So we have our plans for the month, like, set out. Mm-hmm. But I'm just finding it a little bit difficult to figure out, like,
Here's what you do. Jump on every dollar and get the Every Dollar app. Have you done that yet?
Okay. No, I haven't done that yet.
That's the world's best budgeting app, and it's completely free from us.
Okay.
Every dollar. Put it on your phone. Put it on your desktop. And all it does is the purpose of a budget is you want to spend every dollar of your income on paper, on purpose, before the month begins. Your challenge is we don't know what the income is going to be exactly.
Right.
And so what I want you to do is I want you to run your budget at the first of the month based on the lower estimate of what you really think this month is going to be. If you only look out from January 1 to the end of January, you can be pretty accurate at the beginning of the month. But if you adjust it two or three times through the month, you'll be perfectly accurate. But if you do your budget based on low, and then as you make more than you thought it was going to be. So what would be a typical month? What do you think you're going to make this month, total income?
Yes, so this month we're projected to make $4,381.
Okay, perfect. What would you think a typical month is?
That's probably typical.
Okay, so what if we did a $4,000 budget?
Okay.
And then as the money comes in, and you realize you're going to go over $4,000, then you adjust your budget.
Okay.
But you just adjust it as you go along with every dollar. You can do it that way. Another way to do it that I used to do before we had the app was I just make a list. I do a regular budget on $4,000, and that's give every dollar a name before the month begins. And then I would make a list of things I want to do if I get more than $4,000.
Okay, great.
And put that list in order of priority. What would I do if I got $4,001? What would that $1 go towards?
Okay.
If I got $4,600, how many different things could I cover? And you list those out, and then you say, what's the number one thing I want to do if I get above four? And you put that as number one. What's the number two thing I want to do if I get number one done? Put a two, and so on. And so you've got a prioritized spending plan for the money that comes in above 4K. You can do it that way if you want, and then actually enter that into your every dollar budget as you go through the month and begin to really figure out where you are. And that's a way to do it. That'll work. So, hey, good question. You're on it, kiddo. You got this. Woo! It is the first of the year. You guys are doing this stuff, man. You're doing it. Hey, this is your year. This is your year. The people that decide to take control of areas of their life, and they decide way deep down in their decider, not a drive-by, not a passing fancy, but way down in your decider, you decide. Way down there where nobody can change your mind, you decide. No, way down there where no amount of adversity is going to keep you from winning, that's where you decide. Way down in your decider, you decide. When you decide to do that, you can get out of debt. You can get on a budget. You can get your baby step four going into your 401k and be on a track to be an everyday millionaire. But there's no skipping any steps. You lay the plan out. You work the plan. And you're no different. You're not the exception to the rule. You do not get to break the rules.